Welcome to our informative video series. Today, we're going to talk about exercise and staying fit. In this video, we're going back in time to learn how to stay fit, but the old-fashioned way. These days, when you stroll down the aisles of any department store, your eyes must or will be drawn to the appealing collections of labor-saving gadgets. These gadgets can include everything from snow blowers, electric hedge trimmers, TV remote controls, and assorted kinds of DVD players. These collections of easy lifestyle equipments, for a good reason, are enough to alarm every health and exercise expert in the land. These labor savers are associated with the modern generation's slide toward laziness. A large part of the American public isn't getting enough exercise, and these has increased the rate of medical problems like heart disease and high cholesterol, which are linked to a lack of exercise or inactive lifestyle. Lack of exercise is a growing threat to public health, because inactive lifestyle increases the risk for overweight, obesity, high blood pressure, type 2 diabetes, osteoporosis, and certain types of cancer. These days, there's a huge amount of decline in physical activities. These can be blamed on the modern conveniences that are rapidly replacing old-fashioned physical work. Our high-tech and increasingly inactive lifestyle is also to blame. With no more leaves to rake or snow to shovel, people are finding it harder to fit physical activities into their schedules. But it's not that difficult. Consider this. Since you already have certain activities, like going to work and shopping, built into your daily schedules, you can build exercise in as well, and it will help improve your health conditions and standard of living, I mean physically and mentally. Why don't we consider a manual approach to living, which is what I call the old school lifestyle? Certainly, and no doubt, modern devices makes life easier, smoother, faster, and even more appealing, but they also can rob you of one most important thing your body need, exercise. Maybe it's time to dust off the old push lawn mower. And when you watch TV, try changing the channels by hand. During commercials, use the farthest bathroom, especially if it's upstairs. Reintroduce the habit of sweeping your sidewalk and scrubbing your floors. Try new ways of doing things. It's time we realize that, for a 154-pound person, even 10 minutes of light gardening and leaf raking can knock off 50 to 60 calories. Manual approach, or the old-school kind of living, will help engage you in the kind of activities that will improve your blood pressure and blood sugar control, and also put off depression. Declare war on labor-saving devices. Build a different way of thinking, the kind that says, "I'm going to resist as many of these machines as possible." Build your own low-tech exercise tools, inexpensively. For example, take a plastic 1-gallon milk jug and fill it with water. It now weighs around 8 pounds. Include the jug in a variety of stretching and pulling exercises that call for weights. Look for ways to make your surroundings exercise-friendly. When you're doing brisk physical chores, play loud, upbeat music. Research shows it will help you work faster and burn more energy. Try taking the stairs each day, instead of the elevator, or even park at the farthest corner of the parking lot. You can get off before your stop on the subway and walk a few extra blocks to your destination. Before beginning any exercise program or increasing your level of exercise, always check your health condition or consult with your healthcare provider for advice. Here at Knowledgeable, we always say, don't indulge in any sort of unprescribed self-medication. We love you, so love yourself by staying active and healthy. Thank you for watching. Please like, share, and subscribe for more amazing and informative videos. Peace and love.